Have you ever wondered what it would be like to explore a planet with towering mountains that make Everest seem like that little hill in your backyard? Or one with a sky that's always on fire? Welcome, fellow explorers. In this video, we'll be comparing the geography of Earth to some of the most bizarre planets in the universe to see just how unique our universe really is. We'll be exploring the different types of landscapes found on these planets, from diamond worlds to places that rain glass instead of water. But before we take our cosmic journey, let's appreciate the beauty of our own home, Earth. Geography, which is the study of Earth's physical features, helps us understand the world around us and how it has changed over time. I still remember the awe I felt when I first saw a picture of Mount Everest. It was in a school book, and its majesty took my breath away. Everest, standing tall at an incredible height of about 5.5 miles. That's like stacking 10 Grand Canyons on top of each other. And then there's the Mariana Trench, the deepest part of our oceans, plunging about 7 miles below sea level. It's so deep, it's hard to even comprehend. Our planet is a patchwork of climates, from the lush, warm tropics to the dry, hot deserts, the moderate temperate zones with their distinct seasons, and the extreme cold of the polar zones. It's fascinating how one planet can be so diverse. One day you could be sunbathing on a tropical beach, and the next, bundled up against the cold in the Arctic. Earth is a gift from the universe, brimming with natural resources, with the vast oceans, which cover about 71% of Earth's surface, the air we breathe, the fertile soil, the minerals that drive our industries, and the fossil fuels that power our world. It's incredible how much we rely on these resources every day. But what truly sets Earth apart is its ability to support life. It's the only known planet to have water in all three states: solid, liquid, and gas. From the icy polar regions to the hot Saharan deserts and the lush green rainforests, Earth is a testament to life's adaptability and diversity. It's a reminder of how fortunate we are to call this beautiful planet our home. As we venture into the cosmos, we'll discover that the universe has much more to offer. But no matter how fascinating these alien landscapes may be, they only serve to highlight the uniqueness and beauty of our universe. Our first stop on our cosmic tour is Kepler 452b, often dubbed as Earth's older, bigger cousin. Discovered by NASA's Kepler Space Telescope, this intriguing exoplanet is nestled in the habitable zone of a star that could pass for a twin of our Sun. It's a whopping 1,400 light-years away in the constellation Cygnus. Kepler 452b is a super-Earth, with a diameter about 60% larger than our home planet. But what makes Kepler 452b a head-turner is its orbit. It takes this planet 385 days to complete a lap around its star, just a smidge longer than our own year. Its star is a bit of an overachiever compared to our Sun, being about 10% larger, 20% brighter, and 1.5 billion years older. Talk about being a seasoned veteran. This means Kepler 452b has been chilling in the habitable zone of its star for 6 billion years, longer than Earth has been around. With such a long tenure in the habitable zone, Kepler 452b could have had a head start to develop life, given the right ingredients were present. Its strong gravity, about twice as strong as Earth's, could have shaped its geography into a grand spectacle, with oceans that make the Mariana Trench seem like a kiddie pool. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. While Kepler 452b's location in the habitable zone makes it a hot ticket item in the search for potential life, we're still getting to know it. It could be a rocky world like Earth, or it could be playing hide and seek behind a gas giant disguised like Neptune. Future missions and more advanced telescopes may help us unravel the mysteries of this intriguing world. Leaving our older cousin behind, we now venture to a planet that's more Mad Max than Star Trek. Meet HG189773b, a hot Jupiter known for its unusual and frankly terrifying weather where it rains glass sideways. Yes, you heard that right, glass rains sideways. HG189773b is a gas giant exoplanet about 63 light years away in the constellation of Vulpecula. It's a bit clingy with its host star, completing an orbit every 2.2 Earth days. This close relationship gives it a fever of about 1,000 degrees Celsius. The weather forecast on HG189773b is always interesting. The high temperatures on this planet heat silicate particles in the atmosphere to form tiny droplets of glass. These droplets then get caught up in the planet's extreme winds, which can reach speeds of up to 7,000 kilometers per hour. This results in a phenomenon that can best be described as raining glass sideways. You definitely don't want to forget your umbrella or your armor. In addition to its glass rain, HG189773b is also a trendsetter with its deep blue color, thought to be caused by the scattering of light by silicate particles in its atmosphere. This is similar to the way Earth's atmosphere scatters light, causing our sky to appear blue. But don't be fooled, the conditions on HD189773b are far from Earth-like, with the planet's surface temperature is hot enough to melt lead, and its atmosphere is so thick that it rains glass sideways. Now, turning our gaze to a new and exciting world, we set our course for the diamond planet, 55 Cancri E. Can you imagine a planet twice the size of our home and eight times as massive? Well, you don't have to imagine anymore, because that's 55 Cancri E for you. Scientists speculate that 55 Cancri E could be rich in carbon and have a diamond core. Picture that, a planet that could be largely made of diamond. It's like having a gigantic diamond ring, but instead of wearing it, you're living on it. This is due to the high carbon to oxygen ratio, which suggests that the planet's interior could contain up to a third of its mass in the form of diamond. To put that in perspective, if Earth had as much diamond, it would weigh three times as much as it does now. That's like having three whole planets made of diamond. Talk about becoming rich. The surface of 55 Cancri E is also unlike anything we have on Earth. With temperatures reaching over 2,000 degrees Celsius, it's a scorching hot world. This extreme heat, combined with the planet's carbon-rich composition, could lead to some interesting geological activity. For instance, instead of volcanoes that spew out molten rock like on Earth, 55 Cancri E might have volcanoes that erupt with molten diamond and graphite. Now, wouldn't that be a sight to see? But don't get too excited about the prospect of diamond volcanoes. The conditions on 55 Cancri E are far too harsh for humans. It's like a sauna, but 1,000 times hotter and without the relaxing benefits. As we bid farewell to the diamond world 55 Cancri E, we continue our journey to the next fascinating planet, Cort 7b. This captivating exoplanet that is likely covered in lava due to its proximity to its star. Picture standing on a world where the ground beneath your feet is a roiling sea of molten rock. It's like standing on a giant fiery waterbed, but without the fun and comfort. But it's not just the lava that makes Cort 7b interesting. This constant volcanic activity could be forming mountains that dwarf those on Earth. Imagine standing on the surface of Cort 7b, looking out over a landscape of towering mountains made not of rock, but of solidified lava. The peaks reach so high they make Mount Everest look like a molehill. While we don't have an exact number, the mountains on Cort 7b could potentially reach heights several times that of Everest, making them some of the tallest known in the universe. It's like the universe's version of a skyscraper, but without the elevators and office spaces. But what would these lava mountains look like? Unlike the Rocky Mountains we're familiar with on Earth, these would have a unique, almost otherworldly appearance. The lava, once molten and flowing, would solidify into jagged, rough surfaces, creating a landscape of sharp peaks and deep valleys. The color of these mountains would also be striking, ranging from dark, almost black basalt to bright, vibrant hues of red and orange, depending on the mineral content of the lava and how recently it had erupted. It's like a painter's palette, but with colors so vibrant and intense, they put any artist's palette to shame. The constant volcanic activity on Cort 7b would also create a dynamic, ever-changing landscape. New mountains would be constantly forming as old ones were eroded by the planet's harsh conditions. This constant change would make the geography of Cort 7b incredibly diverse and complex. It's like a never-ending game of Tetris, but instead of blocks, you have mountains. And instead of a game over, you get a new, breathtaking landscape every time. So, as we wave goodbye to the lava mountains of Cort 7b, we meet Gliese 1214b. Now, imagine a planet like Kamino from Star Wars, where the surface is completely covered by a deep, endless ocean. But this isn't an ocean as we know it. It's like you've dived into a world where water has forgotten its rules, forming exotic forms of hot ice or superfluid water, states that are completely alien to our everyday experience. It's like swimming, but in a pool that defies the laws of physics. The surface of this planet would be beneath this deep ocean in a thick, steamy atmosphere. It's a challenging environment to visualize. It's like trying to find the horizon in a dense fog, where the sky merges seamlessly with the sea, creating a never-ending horizon. It's a surreal landscape that would make even the most imaginative science fiction writers scratch their heads. The atmosphere itself is fascinating. It's not a clear blue sky like we have on Earth. Instead, it's a thick, soupy mix of water vapor, creating a perpetual planet-wide steam bath. The high temperatures and pressures could lead to the formation of exotic weather phenomena, like clouds of steam or fog that hang low in the sky, or intense storms with rain made not of water, but of hot, pressurized steam. It's like the weather on Earth, but with a sci-fi twist. Gliese 1214b represents a new type of planet like nothing seen in our solar system or any other planetary system currently known. It's like the universe decided to throw us a curveball, challenging our understanding of what a planet can be and pushing the boundaries of our imagination. But even more bizarre planets exist out there. Take Kepler-1b, for example. This planet is a stark contrast to the bright blue we just left behind. It's darker than coal and absorbs almost all of the light that falls on it, reflecting less than 1% back into space. When we talk about an object reflecting light, we're referring to the process where light waves encounter the object and bounce back. This is how we see colors. For instance, an apple appears red because it absorbs all colors of light except for red, which it reflects. Our eyes pick up this reflected light, and our brain interprets it as the color red. Now, imagine a planet like Kepler-1b that absorbs almost all light and reflects less than 1% back into space. It's like having a black piece of paper in a brightly lit room. The paper appears black because it's absorbing all the light hitting it and reflecting very little back to our eyes. It's like the universe's version of a stealth mode. This is quite unusual for a planet, especially a gas giant. Gas giants in our own solar system, like Jupiter and Saturn, are quite reflective. They're like giant mirrors in the sky, reflecting sunlight back to us. However, Kepler-1b is a different story. Its atmosphere is a complex mix of compounds, including titanium monoxide, which contributes to its unusual properties. It's like the universe decided to experiment with its palate, creating a planet that defies our expectations. Now let's dive deeper into the world of Kepler-1b. This gas giant is a realm of extremes. The temperature here sizzles at a scorching 1,800 degrees Fahrenheit, far hotter than any planet in our solar system. This intense heat, coupled with the planet's extraordinary light-absorbing properties, paints Kepler-1b in shades of darkness. It's akin to floating in a vast, hot desert, but without a grain of sand beneath you. It's like the universe's version of a gothic novel, dark, mysterious, and full of intrigue. When we contrast Kepler-1b with Earth, the differences are profound. Earth, with its vibrant blues, greens, and whites, stands in stark contrast to the uniform, dark expanse of Kepler-1b. It's like comparing a colorful, bustling city to a quiet, dark night. Our home planet boasts a diverse landscape of mountains, oceans, and deserts, while Kepler-1b offers an endless atmosphere of hydrogen and helium. And while Earth's climate varies from the icy poles to the hot equator, Kepler-1b is uniformly blistering due to its close proximity to its star. It's like comparing a tropical beach to a hot oven. Both are hot, but only one is enjoyable. So, as we wave goodbye to the dark world of Kepler-1b, we continue our journey through the cosmos. We've seen planets made of water, planets made of diamond, and even planets that rain glass. But what other amazing worlds await us? We're about to find out. As we leave the darkness of Kepler-1b behind, we set our sights on the next fascinating planet, TOI-849b. This planet is a true heavyweight, being 40 times as massive as Earth. It's like the universe's version of a heavyweight champion, but instead of boxing gloves, it's got a whole lot of mass. Scientists believe it might be the exposed core of a gas giant that lost its atmosphere. Imagine a planet like Jupiter or Saturn, but stripped of its outer layers, revealing the solid core beneath. It's like peeling an orange, but instead of fruit, you find a solid core. TOI-849b orbits its star so tightly that a year on this planet passes in just 18 hours. To put that into perspective, if you were to live here, you'd celebrate your birthday roughly 20 times in a single Earth day. It's like having a birthday party, but instead of cake and presents, you get a new age every few hours. But what makes this planet truly unique is its potential geological features. As the exposed core of a gas giant, the surface of this planet could be a landscape unlike anything we had on Earth. it could be covered in exotic compounds formed under the extreme pressures of a gas giant's atmosphere. These compounds, such as hot ice or superionic water, exist in states that are not typically found on Earth. It's like stepping into a world where water forgot how to be water. Hot ice, for instance, is a form of water that remains solid even at high temperatures due to the immense pressure it's under. It's like ice has decided to rebel against its nature, staying solid when it should be melting. Superionic water, on the other hand, is a state of water under extreme pressure where the oxygen atoms form a crystalline lattice while the hydrogen atoms move freely like a liquid. It's like a dance party, but instead of people, you have atoms. It's like the universe's version of a disco, but with atoms instead of disco balls. Wow, what a journey we've been on. We've gone from the familiar landscapes of our home planet Earth to some truly out-of-this-world places. We've stood on the surface of TOI 849b, the largest rocky world yet discovered, and gazed up at the pitch-black sky of Kepler 1b, the darkest known exoplanet. It's like we've been on a cosmic roller coaster, with each planet more thrilling than the last. We've felt the scorching heat of HG189773b, one of the hottest planets known to exist, and imagine the possibility of life on Kepler 452b, a planet where conditions might be similar to Earth. It's like we've been on a cosmic safari, exploring the wild and wonderful landscapes of the universe. But exploring these alien landscapes isn't just about satisfying our curiosity. It's about expanding our understanding of the universe and our place in it. Every new planet we discover, every strange and wonderful landscape we encounter, teaches us something new about how worlds form, how they evolve, and maybe even how they might support life. It's like each planet is a piece of a cosmic puzzle, and with each discovery, we get one step closer to seeing the big picture. It's like the universe is a giant canvas, and each planet is a unique brushstroke. If you've enjoyed this cosmic journey as much as we have, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more space exploration. And now we want to hear from you. Which of these alien landscapes would you most like to visit and why? Share your thoughts in the comments below, and let's continue this journey of discovery together.